So we kept trying to get all the water off the field and everything throughout the whole game. And they decided just to call the game, and then we ended up like messing around in the mud, and then everybody was throwing mud at each other. And me and Shell wrestled in the mud. It was pretty crazy. And yeah, that was pretty memorable.
You were losing three main players due to graduation. How do you think that will affect you next season?
I don't think it'll affect me very much because last year I lost three main players and we went into this playoffs again.
What is one technique that you and your team has done to stay in the game and keep your heads up and not let it go down?
This year our like pickup in our games was Harmon Lewis. He was what we was looking forward to winning for and doing it for him. And like every time we got down, like in a game we had errors or something, everybody was down. We had like had a meeting and we'd say that we needed to keep our heads up and do it for Harmon. And that helped us out a lot when we was down because we knew he would want this for us. And that worked a lot because we thought of him and wanted to win for him, and we ended up doing it in the end. In the championship game, we dedicated it to him. So that was really cool.
Yeah. on my bed. Got your girl summer dumb. Get down, get down, get down to the club. Yeah, be something I know you can come. Shake that, move that, move that. Move it around and get smack that. You even know I'm battling, you gripping my cap. Tell me something you already know about me. Cause I've never wrong tubs. Oh, see, you know I give up. Oh, see, 5 years old.
Two prompts for you guys to choose from. The first one is, tell us two or three things about yourself that people wouldn't know unless you told them. And the other one is, tell us two or three things about your community that people might not know. So we'll write those up afterwards so you can remember them. But just be thinking about that while we show the next two.
Okay, so this is the Marsh Project, and this is a program that's very much like some of the programs that I'm sure you guys have in your area, and I know that there are a couple people here that are working in or going to start video production programs, right? Okay, so this is the Marsh Project. And just to give you kind of an idea about how young people get engaged in doing media, or what these programs can be like.
Toyota package.
Wow, what is that?
HIV, someday AIDS. I can't remember. Well, it looks like you ordered it about three.
What? I didn't know if that was age appropriate. These, you know, these just wherever you stopped them last time, that's when they start playing. I didn't go through and start at the beginning. We just viewed them and made our choices the other day. Sorry about that. Okay. Okay, so this is just the menu, but as you know, with media, especially with video, it's multi-layered. There's not only the video, there's the story, which takes writing, or at least writing questions if there's going to be an interview involved. There are graphics, in case you need to title somebody's name, or if you want to add animation, you can do that. There's music, there are sound effects, so think of it as a lot of layers, and if you do get into it, always be thinking about how you're going to use the ability to incorporate all of those elements, music and sounds, and people's stories. So I think I'm going to show you some audio projects. And Raven here is in some of these. These are just little tiny pieces of them. They're not the whole projects, but they're just sort of to give you an idea. So we have at the Mars Project, we have something called Writing Circle once a week. And people that like to write or just sort of work through issues going on in their life go in and they sit around the table and write. And sometimes afterwards they'll read it to each other or they'll talk about it. It's kind of free-flowing. And so we just grabbed some footage and put it with her poem to kind of demonstrate the sense of it. It's just a little part of it.
My life has been a relocation. Each year moving from desert to redwood tree. From dusty honeydew cabins to cities that left me confused and lonely.
So like I say, these are just little snippets, but there are examples of how you can take things that you write, whether they're poems or just free form, and you can put music with them, you can put sound effects with them, you can put video with them.
I know that I can't break, but every breath just feels so strange. It's like I carry my own weight in pain. Every night I lay awake.
You know, it's whatever's inside the frame that's going to show. Don't have huge amounts of headroom. Keep your headroom kind of small. If somebody's turning their head that way, frame them like this, not like this. Don't dead center frame them, because all this energy back here is just dead.